In this video, I'll teach you how to give a teammate a thumbs up and a whole bunch of other stuff. Hey everyone, my name's Kyle with Microsoft, and in our last video, we introduced threaded conversations in the post area of Microsoft Teams, how to start new topics and how to reply. Let's take a look at some more options and tools for reacting to different posts in Microsoft Teams. Before we talk about reacting to posts, let's look at the icons that a post might have. Posts might have a number of different red icons in the top right, most of them relating to associated notifications. Hovering over them will let you know why they are there. The post has tagged the entire team, the entire channel, you individually, or was flagged as important. There are plenty of options besides just replying to a post. Hover over any original post or reply to see a number of reactions, hearts, thumbs up, and more. Click the ellipses for even more options. We've discussed in a previous video how to save a message, but you can also mark a post as unread. This will flag the channel as having unread messages. If you need to send someone else to a particular message, copy a link to it or send it via email. A copied link will include information regarding who authored the post, the team and channel it resides in, and when it was posted. Clicking Share to Outlook opens a window in Teams tied to the address with which you're signed in, perfect for sending pertinent info along to team members who may not be in that particular team, or using Microsoft Teams, or are outside your organization. Teams supports multiple languages without the need to jump to the web to translate. Just select Translate from the list of options, and any post not in your chosen language will be translated. Select it again to revert to the original language. Our next option is the Immersive Reader. Just like the same tool in Word, Microsoft Edge, or OneNote, this option opens posts in an easy-to-read view where you can control the font size, the background color, spacing, and even have text read aloud to you. Immersive Reader even includes grammar tools and the option to translate from within this view. Hit the arrow button to return to the Posts tab. You can turn notifications for a thread on or off here. Notifications that don't involve flags or tagging a specific team or channel, or you individually, simply change the name of the channel to bold in your channel's list. You may see another menu for more actions related to apps in that channel. Finally, you can pin a post or reply. Unlike saving a message, which bookmarks that post in a menu you can access on your own, pinning a post saves that message for everyone in the channel. You'll see a pin icon appear on the top right, similar to the red notification icons. But pinned posts don't move anywhere in the Posts tab. To quickly see all of the posts that have been pinned in a channel, both by you and your team members, click the Channel Info button in the top right. Below the list of members, you'll see Pinned Posts. Clicking here will take you to the post in the channel, and clicking Pinned Posts will show a view of every pinned post for that channel. Use this to help your entire team keep track of the most important messages. Reacting to a post is more than just giving a thumbs up, and Microsoft Teams is much more than just the Posts tab. For more tutorials on Microsoft Teams, be sure to subscribe to the Expert Zone North America channel, and in the comments below, let us know what you'd like to see in a future video. We'll talk to you again soon. Looking for more info to help you sell even better? Head on over to Expert Zone, Microsoft's online learning platform for courses and classes on all things Microsoft.